Sadie, you want a treat? Look, look. Here, Sadie. A treat? Ready? Get it.
Mmm. What do you think of the Juneberry? No? Not a fan. I think it's because of the crab apple. Oh, yeah. You didn't like that at all. Oh, well.
Look, Sadie. There's berries. Let's go see.
Well, it's that time of year where our Juneberries are producing. My dad found these on our property here at the lake. And he told me about Juneberries. And so it's a cool, rainy morning, and it's a good time to pick some berries. Sadie, do you want to try berries? There they are. They're perfect. So I like the deeper purple ones and the dark red ones. A couple of years ago, my dad was visiting, and he helped me pick a whole bunch just like this, and we made Juneberry pie. I think these Juneberries have a wonderful flavor. Actually, I like them even better than blueberries. So Sadie doesn't like Juneberries, which is surprising because she likes raspberries. She likes a few tomatoes once in a while, and yeah, they say lots of tomatoes, green tomatoes are bad for dogs. But a red tomato once in a while doesn't hurt a dog at all. In fact, it's good for them. Because vegetables are good for dogs. It's one of those clean, crisp, beautiful, quiet mornings. The thunder is rumbling in the distance. The rain has just cleaned these berries. The deer have not eaten all my berries. I probably shouldn't teach Sadie that these are good either, because she might eat them all. Of course, she can't reach them. Well, there's some down here, I suppose. Surprised we haven't had bear in our yard coming out to feast on these berries. Oh, there's so many more over here. This bush is one of the bushes with the very most. There's something growing on our oak leaf. I don't know what that is. There's some acorns here. And there's also some berries around the corner. I'll show you those in a second. I don't know what they're going to be. They're not red yet. I think they're going to turn red. I'm not sure. Look at these. Glad my dad showed me this. He likes to walk around with me and show me the different various plants that I have in my yard. Because somehow he knows all that. Of course, he's had that interest all of his life, so he knows that stuff. He's a smart guy. Some of those birds. This is the kind of peaceful morning that just takes away all of my stress, all of my worries, and I just give it all back to nature. I'll let this food be good for my body and heal me up from any of the stresses that poison my life. Oh, look at that. This is a nice treat. I love having summertime and having berries right here at the lake. Those birds take away stress too. Look at all those. Look at just a handful. Oh, I gotta try a couple of these. So good. I like how Sadie forages with me. Even though she won't eat these, she's still sniffing around for something she could eat or discover or play with. There's just so many of these, I definitely won't be able to eat them all. Leave some for the deer, I guess. A little bit ago, I heard a hawk. I heard some eagles across the lake. They hang out in pairs. The fish were jumping. I can't be out in the boat. Well, I guess I could be out in the boat, but then I'd have to wear a rain jacket. Of course, I'm not wearing a rain jacket here, so why would I wear one in the boat? Can you feel the peace just pouring off of the trees here? birds singing, the berries being plentiful, fresh rain made the berries taste even better. Cleaned them off of all the dust, any bird poo. A little bit ago, the Blue Jays were singing. Oh, there's an abundance of goodness here, right here at the lake. It's so good for us. All my kids were here last weekend. My daughters are here. And we were playing on the lake. Jordan was here. Arya came to visit. David was with his dad and his brother. They had a guy weekend. And it was a great weekend to just get together with family and hang out and make memories, you know. Look at these. There's so much peace coming from this lake place. I'm so thankful for the blessings here. Birds singing, the sound of the lake, the waves, a little distant thunder rolling in the background. We had a campfire last night. There's no mosquitoes right now. Not a single bug is biting me. I think we should go over and check out the raspberries, see how they're doing. What, raspberries? They're not quite ready on that bush yet. That's my little oak tree that I kept in the yard. It was kind of in the middle of nowhere, but oak trees take forever to grow anyway, so. Look, Sadie, what's this? You gonna eat it right off the bush? Nope, you don't get it. Don't drool in my bowl. A few raspberries are ready, and soon we'll have plums. We discovered this plum tree last year. See those green, round green things? Those are going to be plums, which I love plums right off the tree. Especially on a hot summer day when they're nice and warm. I'm going to try this one. Yum. I picked a raspberry a few minutes ago. It had a beetle on it. And the beetle wouldn't get off even though I was holding it. So I had to pick them off and then I ate the raspberry. Oh, look at that abundance. So much goodness here. Okay, I'm going to take you over. There's a bunch of raspberries back there, but there's also poison ivy, so I'm going to wait on that. I found a way to make a path to stay out of the poison ivy. I got to ask you guys about this bush over here. Okay, tell me what this is. What is that berry that's producing? You can see the bush. See a close-up of the leaves. Here's what they look like. Is that choke cherries? I don't know. I'm definitely not going to eat them. They're not ripe yet. Here's a couple that are starting to turn. What is that berry? My dad told me that this is a hydrangea growing here next to the house. Last year, when they flowered, he was right. They were just beautiful. He says dump coffee grains in there. Coffee grounds. What are they called? And it'll turn the color of the hydrangea a little bit. Give it a richer color. Look who found my berries.
Who?
You did.
Oh.
Yeah, Sadie didn't like them. I gave her one and she had... Oh. Started drooling profusely.
Raspberries too.
Yeah.
If we pick up some flour and some nutmeg, then we can make some Juneberry pie.
Yeah.
I found a recipe.
Ooh, yum. Notice she takes my berries away from me. Have any of you ever ate Juneberries or made any recipe out of it? Tell me about that in the comments below. I'm looking to learn about ways to make Juneberries, or the ways to enjoy Juneberries. Well, it's time to have some Juneberries right here in my granola and cream. Look at that, just mix them in. There's not a better breakfast on earth. Oh, there's a raspberry mixed in there too. Look at that. How do you guys eat your June berries? Colors. I am so amazed at the beauty of Earth here, especially tonight. Those colors are just, and in real life, they're 10 times better.